We welcome you to another presentation of the Methodist Connexion, half an hour of hymns and songs and the stories behind them on this Easter day as we celebrate the joy of Christ's resurrection. As we go through, may you experience the power of his presence with you. Let us pray. In awe we come to this Easter Lord's Day, O God. We cannot comprehend the full meaning of the resurrection. We do not understand everything concerning the return of the Lord from the grave. But through the singing of the Easter hymns, give the courage to accept that we cannot fully comprehend the ability to hear clearly the words of the first visitors to the tomb that Easter dawn, that Christ is risen. Indeed, we pray, hear our prayers as we seek to understand this truth. Amen. We begin with the first hymn, All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name. It is numbered 40 in the Voices in Praise hymnal. This hymn was written by a young English minister and was published in 1779 and became known as the national anthem of Christendom. The author, Edward Perrone, was an ordained clergy in the Anglican Church, but was always more sympathetic to the evangelical movement led by John and Charles Wesley. It was not long after Edward left the state church to join the Wesleys in their evangelists' endeavors. Although he wrote a number of other hymns, this hymn is the only one for which he will be remembered. All hail the power of Jesus' name, let angels prostrate fall. It is numbered 40 in the Voices in Praise hymnal. Please sing along with the choir as they lead us.
Straightforward, let angels fall, bring forth the royal diadem.
This next hymn, Jesus Paid It All, was written by Elvina A. Hall and is the basic truth of our Christian faith. It was during a worship experience at the Monument Street Methodist Church in Baltimore, Maryland. Elvina seated in the choir and listening to her pastor, the Reverend George Schrick, speaking of God's love and forgiveness, that she began to think about all that Christ had already done to provide our salvation. Then, as the words of this wonderful hymn came to her mind, she could only find the flyleaf of the hymnal. So she scribbled the words that gave birth to this wonderful hymn of the church. Jesus paid it all. All to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain. He washed it white as snow. It is published in the 1874 circulars and is widely used in churches through the sacrament of the Lord's Supper today. Please join the Gordontown Methodist Choir now as they present Jesus Paid It All. This next hymn is a favorite at this time of the year. Because He Lives, I Can Face Tomorrow. It is numbered 118 in our Voices in Praise hymnal. William and Gloria Gaither is well known for their contribution to gospel music and hymn singing. In an interview several years ago, Gloria related the events surrounding the writing of this hymn, Because He Lives. In the late 1960s, while expecting their third child, the Gaithers were going through a rather traumatic time in their lives. Bill was recovering from a severe illness. It was a special period of anxiety and mental anguish for Gloria. The thought of bringing another child into this world with all of the craziness was taking its toll on her. As Gloria was sitting in their living room in agony and fear, suddenly and quite unexpectedly, she was filled with a gentle, calming peace. It was as if her heavenly father, like an attentive mother, bending over her baby, saw his child and came to her rescue. The panic gave way to calmness and an assurance that only the Lord can impart. She was assured that the future would be just fine, left in God's hands. Shortly after the baby was born, both Bill and Gloria remembered that the power of the blessed Holy Spirit seemed to come to their aid. Christ's resurrection in all of its power and affirmation in their lives revitalized their thinking. To Gloria, it was life-conquering death in their daily activities. Joy once again dominated the fearful circumstances of the day. This experience gave birth to this well-loved hymn. God sent his son. They call him Jesus. He came to love, heal, and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon. An empty grave is there to prove my Savior lives. Because he lives. We remind you, 118 in the Voices in Praise hymn. Our next hymn, Jesus Hath Died and Hath Risen Again, is numbered 124 in the Voices in Praise hymnal. Jesus hath died and hath risen again, pardon and peace to bestow. Fully I trust him from sin's guilty stain. Jesus saves me now. The author of this wonderful hymn is unknown, but it speaks of the experience of one whose sins are forgiven and claim with faith the pardon and peace that the death and sacrifice that Jesus made for the sins of the world. Sin's condemnation is over and gone. Jesus alone knows how. Life and salvation my soul has put on. Jesus saves me now. If you have not accepted this salvation that is offered to whoever believes, I trust that as you listen to this beautiful hymn, this will be your prayer. Jesus saves me now. It is numbered again 124 in our Voices in Praise hymn book. Our next presentation, Christ the Lord is risen today, is numbered 116 in our Voices in Praise hymnal. It is an all-time favorite and one of the church's most popular Easter hymns since it was first written by Charles Wesley just 1 year after his heartwarming experience at the Aldersgate Hall in London, England in 1738. The hymn was written for the first Wesleyan Chapel service in the former Iron Foundry building that was deserted. It is based on 1 Corinthians 15:19. If all of our eternity is to be realized on this side of the grave, we are hopeless and to be pitied. But for the Christian, the resurrection assures us of God's tomorrow. This anticipation makes it possible to live joyfully today, regardless of life's circumstances. I invite you now to sing along with the choir as they guide us in this great song, Christ the Lord is risen today, numbered 116 in our Voices in Praise hymnal.
Christ the Lord is risen today.
I'm so happy that you could have joined us on this Easter Sunday to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. We invite you to join us next week on the Methodist Connection for another exciting experience. You may write to us or email us comments and suggestions you'd like the choirs to sing at Jamaica Methodist Link, 143 Constance Spring Road, Kingston 8. The email address is mainoffice@jamaicamethodist.org. You may also send us messages by WhatsApp on 876-445-5713 or give us a call on 876-925-6768. Do continue to support us by joining us each week in viewing these programs and experience God's blessing through song. We invite you too to make your love gifts for the upkeep of this ministry. Please make checks payable to the Jamaica Methodist Link or use one of the contacts on your screen to arrange for electronic transfer or deposits. Do have a very good day, and the peace of Christ be with you now and always.